Hello friends, welcome to gatelectures.com. I am Siddharth Misra. Today we are going to solve gate previous year questions of subnetting in computer network. This question was asked in gate 2003. The subnet mask for a particular network is 255.255.31.0. Which of the following pair of IP addresses could belong to this network? So firstly, we will define what a subnet mask is. Basically, subnet mask is a 32-bit number. In which ones denote that it belongs to network ID and subnet ID part. And zeros denote it belongs to host ID part. For example, 100. It's a class C network. Then this is network ID, this is network ID, this is network ID, and these two bits belong to network ID part, subnet ID part, and this represent host ID part. So given a network and even its class, we can find the number of subnets and even number of host in each subnet. So number of subnets is equals to 2 to the power number of bits in subnet ID. Here it's 2 to the power 2, that is equals to 4. And number of host in each subnet is equals to 2 to the power number of bits in host ID part. Is equals to 2 to the power 6, which is equals to 64. Out of which first and last are not used. Therefore, number of hosts that can be configured is 62. 64 minus 2. One of the best thing with the subnet mask is that it contains one only at the network ID part and subnet ID part. It contains zero at host ID part. So we can take the advantage of this, and by bitwise handling of any IP with the subnet mask, we can get the network ID to which that IP address belong. That is, given any IP address and the subnet mask, by doing bitwise handling of both, we can get its network ID. So here we have to find which of the two IP addresses belongs to same network. The method to solve this question is IP plus subnet mask is equals to network ID. This is bitwise handling. If the two IPs have same network ID, then they belong to same network, otherwise they do not belong to the same network. So this is the general rule to solve this question. This is bitwise AND. Now some of the things to notice about subnet mask. Bitwise ANDing of any number N with 255 results into N. So we are not going to AND, we are directly going to write N. And bitwise ANDing of any number N with 0 results in 0. So here two things to notice. First two octets are 255. So all the IPs which are having first two octets same only can belong to the same network. And last is 0. So it will result in 0 on ANDing. So firstly, first thing to do, is the first two octets of the IP should match in order to belong to the same network, And lastly, in order to check, we are going to do only ANDing of the third octet, because the last octet will result in 0. So let's eliminate the options. It's first octet 172, 172 matching. Second octet is 57 and it's 56. So both can't belong to the same network. So this option is eliminated. Next, moving to the option number 2. It's 10, it's 35. It's 10, it's 35. So matching, maybe. Option number 3, it's 191, it's 191. It's 200, 300, it's 234. So both can't belong to the same network. Now in option D, we have 128 and 8, 128, 8. Maybe. So we need to match only third octet, because the fourth octet will become 0 on ANDing, because it's 0 here. So let's check for the third octet. So in option B, it's 28. 28 is basically represented as 11100, and we have to AND it with 31. Bitwise ANDing with 31. 31 is represented as this. So it's going to be 11100. It's 28. And the next one is 29. And here we have bitwise ANDing with 31. This will result in equals to 29. So both have varying third octet. They do not match. So second can't be the answer. So we are left with the option D, and D is the answer. Let's check once. We have 129. 129 is represented as 10001. And we have 31 here. So doing bitwise ANDing of both will result in 1. And the second one is 161. 161 is represented as this way, and 31 is represented as this way. So bitwise ANDing will result in 1. So both have third octet same, and the last one is 0. So both belong to the network 128.8.1.0. So this is the network ID for option D, and both belong to this network. So D is the answer. Next question. This question was asked during gate 2004. Here we are given the routing table of a router, and we are asked on which interface will the router forward the packet addressed to destination, this one and this one respectively. So here also we have to do the same. We have to do we have to take this IP, and we will do bitwise ANDing with the subnet mask. And few things to note is that if after doing bitwise ANDing of this IP and subnet mask, the network ID matches with one interface, send it along that. If it does not match it, does not match it with any interface, send it along default. If it matches with two or more interface, send it along the interface with which have the longest subnet mask, that is, then we will send the packet along the interface which has longest subnet mask. This is the rule. So firstly, we will take this IP, and instead of doing with the first subnet mask, do it with the largest subnet mask, so that if it matches with that network, then we are going to send it along that network. Otherwise we will have to match firstly with this interface, then with this, then with this, then we are going to come here. So instead of matching with this 2, we are going to match start our match from here, because it is having the longest subnet mask. So if any packet network ID matches with this interface, then we are directly going to send it here. So it will save our considerable amount of time. So let's start. So doing it in the Ethernet 3, all are 255. So the net result after doing n bitwise ending is n. So we are going to match this 5 and 16. These two things are not matching, so it is not going to be sent along this interface. So we are going to match with this. It's 255.255.255.128. In 128 we have this configuration, and our IP is 128.75.43.16. For 16 we are going to write this, and net this one becomes 0. This is 128.75.43.0. So both the destination IP here and this network ID matches. So packet is sent along this route. Now let's check if we follow the normal procedure, then we are going to use even Ethernet 0. Then we are going to use even Ethernet 0, and we will start matching this IP and it's ending with the subnet mask 255.255.255.0 with 128.75.43.0. This will result in the same value, because this will lead to 0, because actually here we have 16, but ending with this would lead to 0, and this will lead to 45, 75, 128 here. So it matches with this also, but the rule is that if it matches with two or more interface, then send it along the interface which has longest subnet mask. So we are going to send it along Ethernet 1. So one thing to note here is that instead of doing the match from the smallest subnet mask, we are going to do it from the longest subnet mask. So it will be easier and our considerable amount of time will be saved. Now doing the same procedure, repeating the same procedure for the second one. In the second one, we can notice that here we have 192. So our IP is starting from 192, and only this one is having 192 in the beginning. So we are going to only do bitwise ending with this subnet mask. For all the other, for all these two, Ethernet 0 and Ethernet 1, this is not possible to get 128 here. So we are going to do ending with this, and this one is complete subnet mask, that is 255.255.255. This is for a point to point connection. Bitwise ending with this subnet mask will result into the same IP, that is same network ID. And this is not same as this one. These two vary. So this is sent along the default interface. So Ethernet 1 for the first one and default for this. So our answer is default is represented with the name Ethernet 2. So our answer is Ethernet 1 and Ethernet 2, which is option A. This question was asked in Gate 2004. A subnet has been assigned a subnet mask of 255.255.255.192. What is the maximum number of hosts that can belong to this subnet? As I have told earlier that subnet mask consists of network bits, dot network bits, dot subnet bits, dot we can say it can have host ID bits, etc. So ones represent network plus subnet ID bits, and zeros represent host ID bit. So counting the total number of zeros and 2 to the power number of zeros gives us the number of host. And first and last one are not configurable. So total host is equals to 2 to the power number of zeros minus 2. Here we have 255.255.255.192. All ones. This also consists of all ones. This also consists of all ones. And this is represented by 1 1 and then followed by 6 zeros. So total number of host, that is maximum number of host that can be configured, 2 to the power 6 minus 2. 6 is the number of zeros. This is equals to 64 minus 2 is equals to 62. So maximum number of host that can be configured here is 62. Option C is the answer. Next question. This question was asked in GATE 2005. An organization has a class B network and wishes to form subnets for 64 departments. The subnet mask would be. The syntax for subnet mask is equals to. Actually, it's a class B network. So we are going to have first two octets and network bits. And here, partially we are going to have subnet bits and host bit, and the last one will be host bit. So to have 64 departments as subnet, actually 64 departments here represent the number of subnets. And from the format we know that number of subnets is equals to 2 to the power s, where s represent number of subnet bits. So 2 to the power s is equals to 64. This implies s is equals to 6. So we are going to have subnet mask of following format. 255 for the network ID of class B. And in subnet ID part we are going to place 6 ones. And rest host ID, this one is 0, and the end all the zeros. This one is also host ID. This one is subnet, and these two represent network IDs of class B. So it's going to be 255.255. This one calculated to be 252.0. So D is the answer. Next question. This question was asked in GATE 2005. A company has a class C network address, this one. It wishes to have 3 subnet, one with the 100 host and the 2 with 50 host. Which of the following option represents a feasible subnet address subnet mask pair? So here we have been given number of host. So we have to start with the number of host pair. 100 hosts means 7 bits in host ID part. That is network, because it's class C network. And here we are going to have subnet and host ID part. Actually we need 100, therefore 7 bits are reserved in the host ID part. And the 8th bit can be 0 or 1. Okay. And in the remaining two network, we have 50-50. So we are going to have 6 bits in host ID part. So two possible configurations are possible based on the decision of 8th bit in 0 or 1. So let's have first one. This is here. And we are going to have, let's 204.204.204, and for the 8th bit let we have 0. For the 8th bit let we have 0 here. Then its subnet mask is going to be 128 because we have reserved 1 bit now. So it's going to be 128. And for this side we have 204.204.204. And we have to reserve 2 bits here na. So first one will have, now we have reserved 2 bits. Now we have reserved here 2 bits. So subnet mask is going to be 192. Because in the last one, in the first 3 it will be 255, and in the last one we are going to reserve 2 bits for subnet ID and rest 0. So this is going to be 192. So this one will also be 192. And here we have taken 0. So this one will be 10 and this one will be 11. And the rest 0s, 6 0s here. Similarly 6 0s here. So this is going to be 1, 2, 3. So this one will lead to 128 and this one will lead to 192. So let us check, is there any option matching this one? 204.204.0, this one having 128. Okay, no, actually we must have two subnet masks as 192 because we are going to reserve 2 bits. So 128 at two places not possible. We are going to check next one. This one is having 128 at two places. Actually we have two groups having 192 at subnet mask. So firstly we are going to eliminate options by checking this one. So here also 128 two times. This configuration is not possible. Moving to the next one, this is also having two as 128, so this is also not possible. Moving to the third one, 192. So let's check 204.204.128. okay, and having 128, fine, this is not matching with the OR configuration. Let's check another one, 204.204.204.128, and this is having 128 as its. Firstly, let's draw the another configuration and then we will match. Here we will, for the first one, we are going to reserve 1. 1 as 8th bit. So here 1 and 6 zeros thereafter will result it to be 128. So this is going to be 204.204.204.128. And subnet mask is 128 as we have reserved 1 bit only for the subnet. Next, moving to this side, 204.204.204. And if this one bit is reserved at 1, then this is going to be 00. And the next one is going to be 204.204.204.01. This is going to be 64. And subnet mask is 192 because we have reserved 2 bits as explained here. So now we are going to match 204.128 and this is matching. Okay, next one, 204.0/192, this network is matching, and .0164, this network is matching. So our answer is matching with this option. This option is also not matching with any of the required characteristic we have made. So our option is D. So in the exam, check with both the options possible. This is at max going to take 1 to 2 minutes at max. Actually, we have reserved 7 bits here for 100 because the number of IPs that can be demanded is always in the 2 power n. So the next value for 100 is 128. So we have reserved 7 bits here. And for 50, next value in 2 power n is 64. So we have reserved 6 bits. And secondly, it's a class C network, so subnet mask is always going to be 255.255.255. Here in the last one, according to bits reserved for subnet ID, we are going to decide what will be there. If we have reserved 1 bit, then it's going to be 128. If we have reserved 2 bits, then it's going to be 192. So directly I have written 128 or 192. Okay. Ahead there just 255.255.255 because it's default for class C network.